Okay, guys, it's half time now, and Claire are winning by 2 points.
In the blue kitchen, Niamh is creating a canapé of caramelised shallots and gobine tartlets.
It's very surreal to think we're down here and that's all going on up there. But I have to say, I'm not really getting much time to focus in on that. Well, I live in County Roscommon. I'm originally from Dublin. Met a man from Roscommon, married him. We have a farm and we have three children. The most important thing to me about food is actually what it represents, which is love and family.
Rich was the elected leader, but now a natural leader is emerging.
Rich, just so that you're aware, I have to sweat over 100 shallots, OK? So...
chopped.
Shallots. So I'd say I'm going to take three of the hobs in about 15 minutes. So just to let you know. Charlie?
Yep.
When can I start using the oven?
7 minutes.
OK, 7 minutes. Because, Charlie, yours have to get in. And mine have to get in.
Look, I'll come... Dave, if you're doing stuff, I'll just come down and do it.
Hopefully I won't be too bossy. 8 large eggs. Are you in the middle of something now? Into the oven straight away.
Way O'Connor is after him, but Lehan has the chance and he strikes a brilliant goal. It's his first ever championship goal.
With the match in full flow, Diana still has a lot of quail's eggs to peel.
I never realised the pressure for peeling 350 quail's eggs. It's just unbelievable. Better get cracking on.
I'm from Hungary. When I arrived to Ireland, I wasn't sure I'm going to settle here, but I met my fiancé, so yeah, that made it easier.
I don't think that they understand how much there's still left to do.
Yeah, I think because they need to put more pressure on themselves, or Hugh needs to put pressure on the team.
Yeah. The blue team seem pretty quiet.
They do, yeah. No, Richie is in charge. I don't know whether that's the right choice.
I'm not sure if Rich is in charge in there. It's like mutiny in there.
Yeah.
Don't count anything I'm doing here, just count what's in trays.
Yeah.
57 minutes into the game. Cork need a goal. He's got it!
OK, shall I start cutting some of those Scotch eggs and putting them on my plate?
Here. Oh.
Where's my serrated knife gone?
How many of these do we have done, these tarts?
Well, with the ones in the oven...
OK.
We have 216. See, we're 110 short.
OK, well, then, we need to get those in.
OK.
If you slice up the cheese, we'll get these ones done.
Yeah.
And they're done, then.
Same point, half an hour.
I will need three, four shelves.
One at a time.
350 pita breads is also proving to be a tall order for food enthusiast Charlie.
I currently work as a market stall holder. I bake breads, cakes, cookies, scones, and I love it.
That's it now, done. No more pitas.
Okay, all the pitas are cooked, everyone. All the pitas are cooked now.
Prior to that, I was involved in the motor industry for 12 years, and unfortunately, with the change of the economy, that came to an abrupt halt. So I needed to change, and food was always kind of what I was interested in outside of work. So I figured if I need to make a total change of career, I should be doing what I love.
Back in here, as far as Park Cronin, a goal! Park Cronin, only chance he's had so far in this game, and the teams are level.
Sorry, Chef.
Wee.
Okay, there's six.
Oh, no, you can't put that there
for
me.
Let's get this cleaned.
Here, Mark, you're going to have to take that down. Thank
you. That's how we're getting on.
Under pressure, Chef.
Are you okay, yeah? For half past five, yeah?
As the players pick up the pace on the field, Nick and Dylan would like to see a little more action in the blue kitchen.
You're going to be ready?
Yeah. I'm just going to give it to you and you can start plating up. Did someone say they needed help with fish cakes? Because I can stop this for a minute. OK, we're fine here. Now, how many plates of canapés are we sending out in the beginning?
Five, six, seven, eight, 12.
Is anyone under major pressure?
No, I just think, can you get rid...
We just need to keep going, basically.
We're starting to plate up because we're not going to have 350 ready for 5:30 of each. So we're starting off with a selection of the three canapés on the first initial plates. Better to give them a bit of everything rather than, you know, all or nothing.
With the match tied, tantalisingly so, will this be the winner of the All-Ireland? It's over the bar!
Oh, I think somebody scored. It's, I heard a big cheer, and I know it's not for my crab cake just yet, so...
The whistle is about to blow on a new chapter in Irish sporting history. And right now, the kitchens could use some extra time.
OK, guys, what we want to do is maybe stop what we're doing now and start to get the finishing done on the first 75 of each. We're just clearing up the space now and we're going to start getting stuff plated up. We're under pressure, so we're focusing now just on getting the first run of the service out, and then we're going to have to sort of scuttle to get the rest out behind that.
Really need to step on the gas now, guys. I could not stress it more. You cannot afford to not be ready today. You've had 6 hours to do three canapés. It'd be hugely embarrassing if you just don't pull us off.
Yes, chef.
Back out it comes once again to Donal O'Donovan. They would deserve a draw. They get a draw. It's still in play. No longer. It's all over. And it's ended in a magnificent draw at Croke Park.
Just think about it.
Hey, guys, newsflash. Sorry, Rich. It's a draw, which means they're going to come out quicker.
Oh.
OK, because there's obviously no trophy to give out.
Yeah, we're good, I think. We're good, are we? We're starting to play anyway, so...
With the final ending in a draw, can our amateur cooks put in a winning performance?
I think we'll do from now on, pepper them on here so the pepper's not on the plate.
OK, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, we'll do those ones for you.
OK, it's OK.
What else goes on here?
Just keep going with the blinis.
Do you have lemon zest or anything?
No, that's it.
That's it?
Yeah, just keep going with the blinis. How long for that beef? For one more, for three
it's
more?
Three beef.
Three.
Guys, hello. There needs to be two pieces in this competition. And it's time to slip in the second piece.
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
A little bit kind of stringy on my ones.
Watch yourself.
With the replay date set, the players file into the VIP lounge for post-match analysis and hopefully some food. The first of the canapés start to leave the kitchen. The red team have created mini Yorkshire puddings with seared beef, Scotch quail's eggs, and smoked salmon Bellini canapés with creme fraiche. The blue team are serving caramelised shallot and gubeen tartlets, crab and ginger wontons, and slow-roasted lamb shoulder with baba ganoush in pita bread.
It was very nice, like, you know, it was nice and kind of simple, nice and small. It wasn't too kind of big, but very tasty, to be honest, like,
sorry. I've tried a number of the canapés, they're very, very nice. It's Scotch quail's eggs, it's very tasty.
Just salmon and the mini Yorkshire puddings, and both of them were beautiful.
The real highlight was the crab and prawn and chilli ball. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Good bean tart is lovely, but the crab and chilli would be the same. Delicious.
Had the Bellini, which was just okay. I just felt it was lacking that little bit of spice and a little bit of taste.
After an exciting roller coaster of a game, they give us a little perk and a lift up. Lovely.
Today's task was about teamwork.
Mm.
Yeah? Generally, this team produced better work. However, I don't think they stood as a team. Both leaders, I don't think, led very well.
Mm.
Where Rich was just sort of like, happy days, let's just get on with it, you do that, I do that, and...
Hugh, he did his best to try to motivate everyone, but I don't think that the team responded to him. And if it wasn't for people like Diana, who just was upbeat, worked in every area she could, helped everybody out that she could, I don't think they'd have really produced any sort of consistency.
Yeah, for me, the team player in the blue team
was Niamh. Once she had finished her job, she went and asked everybody else around the kitchen did they need help, which is commendable, because the others were quite happy to stand in their little corner, do their tasks, do their jobs, without actually helping the other people.
OK, guys, that's it. End of service. Well done. Well done. Give yourselves a pat on the back.
We're done. Thank you very much. Well done. Even though the place is like a bomb site.
It's a happy bomb site.
Yeah.
I think I learned that there's, you know, I might like to think that I can get everything done, but you have to be practical. So maybe I just need to know my limitations a bit at this stage, not put my hand up for all the donkey jobs.
Hugh did lead us well. That's not why I'd be disappointed. You don't realise how quick the time goes, and we're just pushed to get things on the plate.
I think on the team task, the judges are probably going to look at whether or not people can actually work in that dynamic. I think the fact that we got a fair amount of food out at a high quality that looked good is sort of testament that we got on pretty good on this task.
I think we had made the plans to have regular checkpoints to see where we were with prep and, you know, getting ready for service. But that kind of fell by the wayside. So I think there is a time for working fast, and I think there could have probably been a bit more urgency amongst all of us, including myself.
I don't really know what time it is. I don't even know if it's still today, is it? But, you know, we'll be back tomorrow, I'm sure, cooking something. And, yeah, I guess someone's going to be on their way, but I don't know. We'll find out.
The following morning, and the teams face Nick and Dylan back in the MasterChef kitchen.
Good morning, and welcome back to the MasterChef kitchen.
Teamwork and an understanding of its importance is crucial in a professional kitchen. If you don't work together, the outcome of success is impossible. Diana and Niamh, please step forward.
How you worked within your teams yesterday in Croke Park impressed us the most. So as a reward, we are giving you the day off. So will you please now leave the kitchen?
Oh, I can't believe it. I thought we were gone. Why has he said my name? I'm delighted. I'm so delighted.
Just relieved and just so happy.